I'll read back a little bit. Okay. People love a mystery, added Daniel. People looked at his videos and saw that he set something up beforehand that proved he could be trusted with his word. He said, after 3 years to the day, that he posted a video of himself repeating a certain sentence over and over again in a foreign language, that he'd post a video to reveal its answer. The video in the strange language, Marathi, actually, was what he called a sleeper cell wake-up call. Well, as I said, 3 years to the day of posting the sleeper cell wake-up call titled The Mystery Call, he posted a video to let you know what he was saying in Marathi and let it known again that the repeating sentence was to possibly activate sleeper cells. He was a terrorist Muslim, asked Sally. No, said Daniel. Thank God he was full of questions. I shudder to think what world-shaking horror a guy like him could have easily brought onto the earth if he didn't first come upon those sayings and scriptures in the Quran that sounded stupid and crazy to him. He could have become the monster of monsters. No, he found the stupid and evil scriptures in the Quran and Hadith first, stopping him from becoming the doomsday machine he would have absolutely become. The sleeper cells he secretly created were for something else, and I'm not quite sure what they were he created them for, but I'm betting they weren't for terrorist activity at all. In his video he posted on YouTube, he said they should be harmless if they were to be activated. I believe him. What was it? Asked Sally with a look of concern in her eyes. Again, it was a repeated message that it found out he believed might activate those sleeper cells. But again, not Muslim ones, according to his journal. Not terrorists. But being that he was a Muslim, I'm betting it got the FBI and Homeland Security making a special file for him again, just in case. And the sentence was, asked Sally, looking a bit scared, messages from the edge of Earth are coming. Messages from the edge of Earth are coming. Repeated over and over again, but in Marathi, which he says he started about 10 years ago, which means it was something he started even before he even became a Muslim, which means that although the project was to expose Islam, that it was something more than that at its beginning. And if so, it means he had a lot more patience to carry out whatever project he was working on at the time he posted the videos of himself in his underwear. That messages from the edge of Earth repeat is a video of a video that shows him younger. And people can see that for themselves. It lets people know that he might be a complete and utter wacko, but he was a serious and very complex wacko with incredibly deep, possibly occultic ideas that captured interest in him. And when people saw that video that exposed the meaning of what that video was in that rare East Indian Hindi language called Marathi, they started seeing his videos like he was planning. They started seeing his videos like he planned 3 years earlier when he was still thought of as a true blue Muslim. And they even started accidentally crossing the bridges of cyber ether to see his anti-Islam videos. And if he lived to put on the video that answered the question as to why he looked like hell in that student's video of him in my classroom, man, well, I'm betting The number of millions. I'm betting that 1,053,000 and counting viewers currently would probably escalate exponentially, along with the exposure of those very damning videos on Islam, especially if he then put on videos that bridged his Samson option and science videos with his Islam videos in a far more powerful way, which he was planning according to that journal of his on that flash drive. So I looked up and noticed it wasn't snowing anymore, but the only words she uttered were Samson option. Samson option. Daniel looked at Sally, then said, right. The Samson option. He was going to let nature finally take its course in front of the world and destroy the one thing he was most vain about, his hair. It was the lack of hair from Samson's head that helped Samson bring down the Temple of Dagon. Before Samson could bring it down, he had to be shorn of hair and humiliated. This guy, this Niles Neville, literally did do a sacrifice as he said he would. He did that, which he used to dread most. Go bald. He sacrificed his youth and hair. All he needed to do was start putting the videos of his rapid aging on the net, and it would freak so many people out. All his videos from Christian Prince and himself and exposed Islam would go viral. Well, he lost his hair. And that student video of him in the classroom proved it. He did complete his Samson option. He went bald before the last leaf of a tree fell. Not to bring down the Temple of Dagon this time, but to bring down the house of Allah, Islam. He literally went bald rapidly to help free the world from Islamic terror. Sally thought for a while and said, when did he post that video called the Samson Option 1? Daniel looked up, thought, and said, there is no date, but when I came upon it and did the math, I noticed that he posted it on the day he confronted his Muslim stalkers on the phone in my classroom. Apparently, only the threat of death would get him to unleash the first video, holding out 3 years later to release the last of those special videos in chronological order, which will now never come. And it was that day, the day he became like a caged panther, that he put on that first video. And to this day, it's gaining a huge amount of attention with just that crazy video of him in his underwear. Then you noticed that the snow had stopped. He then said with excitement, oh, thank God, maybe I can get this thing to Vegas after all. You're going to Las Vegas, asked Sally? That's where I'm going. That's where I'm taking the potatoes, said Daniel. He then put his hand over the dial for the lights and said, you know, I bet we are so far away from an artificial light source that the stars will be killer to look at. Killer? Asked Sally, with a little worry in her voice. Killer, like cool? Asked Daniel. But is it still cloudy? Daniel climbed out of his truck and looked up. There was a big patch of starry sky. And so ends the story. The flash drive. Change here. Okay, this next story I'm about to read in my novel is called The Night Journey. As Sally debated about coming outside into the cold and seeing what the night sky might look like so far from the city light, a light of a laptop computer was glowing in the back of the van used hours earlier as a weapon as it headed north while a recording of Quran 9 was being recited in Arabic over a speaker. The recitation wasn't coming from the laptop, but from speakers in the van that was pretty damaged and beat up. Wind was whistling through the window that was broken out, for the van was one of three other vehicles used as a weapon against Daniel Toshiro Kobashi's truck. The face of the sub, called Niles Devil, was seen talking on a video. As he talked, there was murmuring in the background coming not from the laptop, but from those near that laptop, sitting in the dark of the van. When a finger hit the play button on his laptop, the voice of the sub came on saying, "Hello and welcome to Project Jihad, an experiment with the world's fastest growing religion that is destined to either have you or your grandchildren on prayer rugs with their patooties up in the air." There was a sound of cussing from the voice of the one who was playing the video on the laptop. The voice came from the Muslim who hijacked the truck the day before. The van driver, known as Muhammad Yusuf Yasir, smiled. The sub went on with, "Patooties in the air, five times a day, every day, for the rest of you or your their lives, to keep from paying the jizya tax, or else." In other words, this is an experiment with Islam using a bunch of CDs called Project Jihad. If you're seeing this message, then you probably know that this video, then you probably know that this intro was burned onto the CD with a handful of videos that deal mostly with questioning Muslims about their faith. All CDs contain a small, complete video series that uses the very Quran itself to challenge Islam when the Quran says it's a confirmation reminder of that which was before it. In other words, it exposes Quranic scriptures where the Quran says it's a confirmation and reminder of the Bible, which, if you think about it, totally flies in the face of all Muslims who try to preach that the Bible is corrupted, which, if you think about it further, doesn't make sense if all his words are unchangeable, like the Quran claims. And the Muslim who hijacked the truck yesterday, named Muhammad Atif, stopped the image of Neville, grumbled, and said, "He doesn't know what he's talking about." Atif tapped on the laptop mouse again, restarting the sub's image. The sub, Niles Neville, said, "This CD you are possibly reading this message off of is just one version of possibly hundreds like it. But there aren't that many copies of the CD you are reading this off of, so feel free to turn it into a possible collector's item, especially if the project becomes more than just an experiment with Islam as planned. Every CD that was launched, possibly like this one, is deliberately made incomplete, containing only parts of a story that is a science fiction fantasy parable on how to end the war on terror. In other words, it gives instructions on how to end Islam." "Never!" shouted the angry truck hijacker, Atif. "What?" asked the young Muslim who mimed throat cutting, who went by the name of Muhammad Zaid Hara Jabir. The image of the sub continued with, "Or of an audio debate questioning a Muslim on Islam, a Muslim who is superb at jihad the pen as he uses Al-Taqiyya, basically licensed line for Allah, due to Quran 328 and 1606, which allows Muslims to lie, and this Muslim uses Taqiyya with great effect. If you're really lucky, you might be, at most, one of five to own a CD that contains two mystery stories in their entirety. A rare find indeed." I've got to turn this off. "A rare find indeed."